Welcome to another edition of Progressive Retail, exclusively on the CBT Automotive Network. I'm Cory Mosley. Welcome to the show. Today, we're going to be talking about engagement. Now, I've addressed engagement as part of my seven disciplines of internet sales series previously, but today we're taking a little different approach. I'm going to share with you five things that I think is inhibiting engagement throughout the dealership. So not just your internet or BDC department, but on your showroom floor and your overall engagement with customers. So number one I want to share with you is this idea of the failure to be present. And when I talk about the failure to be present, I mean the failure to be in the moment. Many times I see sales professionals working with customers, but they're not completely 100% there. Now, we certainly have personal lives and you may have different factors and things you're thinking of, but certainly when you're trying to create effective engagement, which helps you close more deals and affects gross profit, the key to be present in the moment is so, so important. You know, you might be thinking about deals that you got pending, what the commission's gonna look like this week, or some personal issues, but I encourage you to focus on being present as much as possible. You'll see this in your meetings where someone may be on their computer or looking at their email. That's a failure to be present. So how can you improve that if you're plagued by that also? Number two, something I like to call selective hearing. Now, selective hearing is also known as waiting to talk. I hear this many, many occasions inside internet departments and BDCs. Also, when I see presentations with salespeople, whether presenting numbers or doing walkarounds, this idea of selective hearing, also known as waiting to talk, is becoming a key problem when we're trying to create engagement. As I listen to phone calls all over the country, I'll hear people on the phone so interested in getting to their spiel or getting through their script, they're not actually listening to what customers are saying. So do you suffer from selective hearing? I remember one of my early deals, before I really actually learned professional sales, I would just say kind of whatever was natural when it came to customers. And in the early days of dealing with internet customers, I really had this belief system, or it was told to me by salespeople who ultimately I don't think wanted to see me succeed, that I couldn't make any money in the internet department and it wouldn't work for me and you'd have to give all the cars away. So I had bought into that mentality. And I remember this fateful day, and I tell this story very frequently, coming back from the lot with a customer and sitting down and just assuming I wasn't going to make any money, assuming that they wanted to steal the car from me. And I remember saying to him, "Sir, you're obviously an educated internet consumer. If you will just tell me what you'd like to pay for the car, I will check with my manager and see if we had a deal." Now, I know, don't send me any emails. I know that was super, super weak, probably the weakest line I ever said in my professional career in sales. But nonetheless, it's what I had. It was a mentality that I had at that time. And luckily, that guy was not listening that day because he pointed at the MSRP on the worksheet and said, "Oh, no, I'll pay that." Now, I had a moment of selective hearing because I was so used to potentially people giving me numbers or ridiculous offers. I had already had my rebuttal. My rebuttal was going to be, "Wow, Mr. Customer, I've never seen a price that low. Let me go speak to my manager and see if we would have a deal." So I actually had to catch myself because I was so focused on my spiel, I was so ready to handle the rebuttal. And then when he offered me a full gross deal, I didn't quite know what to do with myself. So I literally had to maintain my composure and walk all the way over to talk to my manager and tell him that we had a deal at full list. And at that time, it was my first full list deal, but it also changed my mentality. And it taught me that I have to allow the customer to share the information, me process that information, simply not just try to get to the next stage or the road to my sale or the road to my script. Number three is something I like to call using tension as a tool. You may know this as a takeaway in our business. So I gotta tell you, and most of you are seeing this in the marketplace, right? Where's the average consumer's BS meter right now? You probably say it's kind of, you know, through the roof. They're have access to so much information, whether it's correct information or false information. There's a lot of empowerment in the marketplace at the consumer level. So I find it interesting when I see tension being used as a tool or that kind of takeaway, because I think many times in the retail environment, it's not as successful as it has been. something I like to call the law of diminishing returns. If you continue to do an action over and over again, at some point, it loses its effectiveness. So attention as a tool is you've worked a deal six ways from Sunday. You folded your worksheet, you know, all so it's like origami from going back and forth with the numbers. They've met all the alphabets in the building, the GM, GSM, the DDSW, whoever you got. And we'll say something to the customer like, well, you know, I can only, this offer is only good till tomorrow at 5 o'clock. See, you're using tension. You're using this tension here as a tool for closing. And I would challenge you that that is going to inhibit your ability to better engage your customers. So think about that in your next engagement or the next time you try to simply use a takeaway to incentivize a customer. Now, takeaways can work, but they have to be done with the right customers. And that goes back to understanding personality types and making an investment into that type of learning. Information that we do cover on our online tool, Mosley 24/7. Number four, over-familiarity. See, this is an interesting one because we all want to have this personality, right? We want to be outgoing salespeople, naturally outgoing, engaging, also considered extroverts. But what I find too often is, again, being disconnected from the customer, especially initially. So referring to a customer as your buddy or your pal or your friend or doll, if you want to get yourself into some trouble, is problematic in the long run. Now, that may be your natural personality. But if you haven't connected with the right customer, you're going to have a backfire scenario where you're creating a scenario for customers of familiarity as if you all are buddies because you want them to be comfortable. But that attitude may actually result in them becoming uncomfortable. Number five, explaining failure. This is an interesting one because most customers don't want to hear why we failed to deliver. You know, we've pitched quick, easy, and convenient on the telephone, and then we've backed them up in F&I for 3 hours. And then we want to explain that. Most consumers today would rather you simply correct the issue or the problem and then move on, not simply explain why you have failed to deliver on that item or create justification for what's happened. Because explaining failure really creates a scenario that affects CSI, it can affect gross profit, and a host of other areas that could actually mean no deal at all. So ultimately, how you engage, and more importantly, how the customer engages back with you is super, super important. And I think we could all agree that the focus should be to remove as many barriers as possible. Well, that's our show for today, but before I let you go, I want to make sure that you know that myself, Jennifer Suzuki, and CBT's own David Kane are hosting the Internet Sales Performance Summit July 19th in Irvine, California. I want you to check it out. Go to ISPS2017.com because we'd love to meet you and participate in your continued education to drive your income and improve your sales. Well, this has been another edition of Progressive Retail exclusively on the CBT Automotive Network. I'm your host, Cory Mosley, and I'll see you next week. We'll